Hi students, and another topic is flower. So what is flower? The flower is the reproductive part. Flower is the reproductive part. Which flowers? Plants produce flowers for reproduction, to give new ones, to give new ones. You know, plants also to produce offsprings in every generation, that is necessary to continue the life of the plant. So that is the purpose. The plant shoot is modified. The plant shoot is modified. So nothing but stem is modified into flowers. Why the stem is modified into flower? To produce new ones. To produce new ones. So every generation to produce variety of plants and variety of generations. So we can discuss another class how it is possible. Varieties are, new varieties are formed every generation. So before discussion about pollination and fertilization, we need to information about flower. Students, the flower is one of the important reproductive part of the plant. It can modify shoot. The which purpose? The plant of shoot is modified into flower for reproduction. Now this is the flower, diagram of the flower. It have mainly four important floral parts. Nothing but floral leaves. How many floral parts are present? Four. And first of all, before discussing about floral part, every flower produces axis. The flower is produced from axis is called peduncle. Now this is the peduncle. Two branches are there. Now this is peduncle. Now this is pedicel. Look here, students. The flower produced from peduncle. Okay, the stalk of the flower is called pedicel. The apex of the pedicel, idi axis antaru dinni. Deen nunchi flower form avutundi ee axis nunchi. So dani peduncle antaru. So peduncle nothing but floral axis. It produces flower. The stalk of the flower is called pedicel. Now this is pedicel. Ikkada nunchi idi pedicel. Now this is pedicel. The stalk of the flower is called pedicel. Now this is peduncle, this is pedicel. The first one is peduncle, the second one is pedicel. Okay, now this is the floral axis. This is stalk of the flower, is nothing but pedicel. The apex of the pedicel slightly condensed is called thalamus. Thalamus is the seat of floral parts. It's very important. Thalamus is the seat of floral base. Nothing but the thalamus is the base of four floral parts. So above the thalamus, how many floral parts are present? Four: calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. What is the first one? Calyx. Second, corolla. Third, androecium. Fourth, gynoecium. So the calyx and corolla both are non-essential parts. Why the calyx and corolla is called non-essential part? Because those are not involved in pollination and fertilization process. But androecium, gynoecium are called essential parts. Why they are considered as essential parts? Because both are involved in fertilization and pollination. So there are four floral parts are present: the calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. First one is calyx, second one is corolla, third one is androecium, fourth one is gynoecium. Calyx and corolla are called non-essential, and androecium, gynoecium are essential. We, because those are involved in fertilization process, and the first two are not involved in fertilization process. And if it is the flower have calyx and corolla, the flower is called chlamydous flower. Chlamydous flower, students, very important word. Chlamydous flower is nothing but calyx, corolla is present. If the calyx and corolla is absent, that flower is called achlamydous flowers. So nothing but naked flowers. Okay, but it is a chlamydous flower because calyx and corolla is present. and androecium is represent male reproductive part and gynoecium represent female reproductive part. Indulo androecium emo male reproductive part, then gynoecium is female reproductive part. And calyx and corolla, what is the function of the calyx and corolla? Calyx is the protector of the floral parts. All floral parts are protected by calyx. And corolla is very beautiful and very attractive. We can discuss in another class. And corolla is very beautiful to attract the insect for pollination. And calyx is protective layer and to attract the insect, corolla. And androecium is male, gynoecium is female part. Okay, if it is male, it is female, it can attract the insect. Now this is the corolla, it can attract the insect. Are you clear? And it is a protective layer of the flower. So it a very important point is that the unit of calyx is called sepal. The unit of corolla is called petal. The unit of androecium is called stamens. The unit of gynoecium is called carpel. Students, once again, the unit of calyx is called sepal. The unit of corolla is called petal. The unit of androecium is called stamens. The unit of gynoecium is called carpel. How many floral parts are there? Four. First calyx, second corolla, third androecium, fourth gynoecium. So it is bisexual flower. Why it is bisexual flower? Because male reproductive part androecium, the female reproductive part gynoecium, both are important. Such flower is called bisexual flower. Now it is bisexual flower. It is bisexual flowers. And also unisexual flowers are present. Unisexual nothing but only one is present. If it is have androecium gynoecium, such flowers are bisexual. Look here. In this one only gynoecium is present. Now it is female, this is female flower. This is female flower, students. Okay. And if it is have only stamens, it is male flowers. Male flowers. So only stamens are present. ఇదొక్కటే ఉందనుకోండి gynoecium ఉంటే అది female flower. Stamens, ఇలాంటి stamens ఉంటే అది male flowers. ఈ ఇద్దరు ఒకటే దాని ఉన్నారనుకోండి gynoecium and stamens both are reported in only single flower. That is bisexual flower. That is bisexual flowers. Are you clear? Then calyx is very important role. So it can, if it is the unit of calyx is called sepal. Sepals are two types: gamosepals, polysepals. Gamo means united. Poly means free sepals. Are students? So two types are there: gamosepals, polysepals. Gamosepal means united. Polysepal means free, and it is a protective layer. The second one is corolla. So corolla, unit of corolla is nothing but petal. So it is also two types: polypetal, gamma petal. Gamma petal nothing but united, fused, and polypetal nothing but free. So based on corolla, the corolla is forming different shape and different colors to attract insect. Are you clear? So colors, calyx are only always it is a green in color, calyx. But corolla is forming different color and different shape and different morphology. And to which purpose corolla is very big and it can express different morphology? Purpose is to attract insect for pollination. For pollination, we will discuss another class. But based on androecium and gynoecium, the flowers are two types: unisexual and bisexual. You know, students, based on production of the flowers, the plants are two types. For example, if the plant is have only unisexual flowers, that plant is called monoecious plant. Monoecious plants look on both male and female flowers. Male and female flowers are present on the same plant. That is monoecious.
If it is have, if the plant is produced two flowers, male flower and female flower, that is monoecious. That is mono, nothing but bisexual. Why it is bisexual? Male, female, both are produced from single plant. That is bisexual or monoecious. Dioecious means male and female flowers born on different plants. That is dioecious. That is unisexuality. So we can discuss another topic, sexual reproduction in plant. What is monoecious? What is dioecious? And we will discuss another class. So what is the corolla and what is androecium? What is gynoecium? Then after fruit, then the topic is completed. In next another classes.